From year to year, month to month, week to week, and day to day, people across the world are obsessed with a phenomenon that is professional wrestling. But why? 101 reasons to love professional wrestling. There are many components of professional wrestling that should be both understood and celebrated, in no particular order. Reinvented characters. Cultures change. People change. The world itself as we know it changes. When this occurs, one has two choices: adapt or watch it pass you by. Actors will change their look and character performance for each role they land. An athlete might switch jersey numbers or add some questionable tattoos to change up their appearance. The persona that connects to art can get a little more creative to meet the visual demands of the audience. Musicians do this all the time. Rock star icons like David Bowie went from human to alien to whatever he wanted. The Beatles went from clean-cut mop tops to hippies, and even Elvis went from a standard 50s garb to sequin capes and jumpers. Of course, there's the likes of Madonna or Lady Gaga switching it up and keeping their pop star images interesting and a talking point. Change is never a bad thing. It allows a reset, an opportunity to stay interesting, new visuals to sell merchandise, and a chance to engage the crowd in a new way. In professional wrestling, this can easily happen with a reinvented character. A reinvented character can be a renaissance of a performer's career, or just another destination on their journey. Sometimes an act will get stale or just never connect with the crowd. What will sometimes happen is these people will get a second chance. The performer gets to re-debut as a new repackaged character or come back with a refreshed version of what's already been established. And the character-driven performance that is professional wrestling thrives on renovation, evolution, and capturing the imaginations of its viewers. A reinvented character is a proven way to accomplish this. Sometimes it's as simple as evolving from lower card to the main event. Steve Austin was stunning and the ringmaster long before becoming Stone Cold. Triple H went from a Connecticut snob to a cerebral assassin on his way to becoming a multi-time world champion. Glenn Jacobs would portray various characters before the WWF, but he would also play various characters in the WWF. He started as an evil dentist named Isaac Yankum before moving on to a fake version of Diesel, and then finally the former world champion and Undertaker's brother, Kane. And now he's a mayor in Tennessee. Certain characters do work, but also don't meet the expectations or needs of a wrestling company's story. Freshening up is vital in these cases. Hulk Hogan rode out his all-American red and yellow character for years on the highest level a wrestler could. To rejuvenate his character, he turned on the fans and embraced a new Hollywood Hogan persona. Bray Wyatt came in as a Southern cult leader and has renovated his character into the bizarre fun that is the Firefly Funhouse and the horror monster of Fiend. Sting started off as a colorful face-painting surfer for the early part of his career, before striking gold by copying the movie The Crow, and then striking cold with ripping off the Joker in TNA. Mick Foley was Cactus Jack, Mankind, Dude Love, and eventually just himself. Then there's those who never quite make it to the top of the card, but celebrate longevity because of their ability to get different characters over with the crowd. Charles Wright started off as Papa Shango in the early 90s, and would go on to be the supreme fighting machine, Kama, before developing his most beloved character, the Godfather. Scott Hall was one of the best of all time and is definitely a Hall of Famer. But he grew from the Diamond Stud in AWA to Razor Ramon in the WWF, and then the NWO version of Scott Hall in WCW. Chris Jericho has pretty much always been Chris Jericho, but he has changed his character up every couple of years to remain fresh and extend his already legendary career. The same could be said for Matt Hardy, Dustin Rhodes, Raven, Barry Darso, and many others who have continued to hone their craft inside the ring while reinventing their personas. Just about everyone in professional wrestling that has had a long career has changed their on-screen character up to stay relevant. A character has to resonate with the audience or serve a purpose. The facade of a wrestler is essential to the business.